Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand.
Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakai Kodash. All blessings, honor, glory, and power be unto the Heavenly Father, whose name is Yahweh, and His only begotten Son, our Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh Shai. And double honors to the apostles and the elder bishops of Great Millstone who taught me this truth. And salutations to the elect scattered abroad throughout the four corners of the earth. My name is Amuan Gabar, and I'm back with another lesson. Little one's quick, edifying, straight, and to the point. In the title's video, somewhere along the lines, they've been casting demons this whole time. Alright? They've been casting demons this entire time. Somewhere along those lines. And obviously, you know, that's a no-brainer. Like, no duh. Esau has always been casting spells and casting demons. And the reason why I titled this, those two words, I want to emphasize casting demons, right? Casting in demons, which is why I titled it, they've been casting demons this whole time. Now, as you see here on the screen, I'm sure you read it by now. I don't want to say much, but you type in this and then you go to images. And I've been seeing this a lot lately. And when I first seen it, I thought to myself, yeah, look at Satan at work again. You know, there's nothing hidden that shall not be revealed, right? So I've seen this a few times, and I've seen it again today. You know, this shirt online when I was, you know, on my phone, just, you know, scrolling through things, and then it popped up again. So let me pick one of them. So yeah, like this right here. You see where it says the middle demon? So I was like, you know, I forget what you call them, like crypto messages or crypto something, you know, hidden messages, right? So you got the word demon. So I was like, all right, you know, Satan, of course. So I'm like, you know what? Let me see if the other words that aren't highlighted mean anything. So I took the word P-R-I-T-H. All right, P-R-I-T-H from the word. All right, pride, of course, and then month. So P-R-I and then T-H, the last five remaining words. I took those words and I did this. I went to Google and look, this is not what I'm showing you, but just to show you an example of them casting spells, you got a Jake man, a Jake male, Vogan. All right, Isaiah 3:9 all the way. You know, feminine is all hell Vogan. But anyway, I took the P-R-I. All right, P-R-I-T-H. And let me go to this right here. It says Wisdom Library. And when you go to it, I'm going to skip the introduction, just go straight to the meaning. The word P-R-I-T-H, prith. All right, as you see here, prith in Sanskrit glossary. It says prith, to extend, to throw, cast, to send, direct. All right, so prith, P-R-I-T-H, to extend, to throw, to cast, to send, and direct. And that's where I get the title for this lesson. All right, they've been casting demons this entire time. So those two words, all right, P-R-I-T-H, and then demon, prith, demon, casting demons. It's all in this word right here, and it's all in this month. So that's why I titled it, they've been casting demons this entire time. And Esau been casting demons from the time this man came into power. You know, I'm going to get the scriptures real quick. You know, but this man, this is how he operates. All right? Now, you go to Google, because I just went to Google. I'm going to type in Google again. And this is popped up. This is prith demons right here. This is casting demons. All right, this is casting spells. All right, nobody need to see this. You know, and then on top of other things, You know, this is being force fed down people's cranium, you know, through their brain, penetrating their spirits, you know, attacking children, you know, starting with the children, you know, even adults getting, you know, they getting attacked and giving heed to Satan and them seducing spirits and going left to the point of no return. You know, so hey, this place is out of here. This is definitely Babylon the Great. All right, the harlot, the witch. Okay, the mistress of witchcraft. Let me get this real quick. Luke 12:2. For there is nothing hid, excuse me, there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, neither hid that shall not be known. So eventually everything comes to light. Everything comes to light eventually. And further proving that we at the end of this man's kingdom is because all his secrets, all his spells, all his dark enchantments are coming to light. And the ones doing it are the prophets. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is using the prophets to uncode, so to speak, or decode the hidden mysteries of who this devil is and his agendas and his enchantments. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is doing that. All right. And he's using his prophets to do it. That's why Amos 3:7, let me get that real quick, says what it says. Amos 3:7. Surely the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets. So Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai reveal his secrets to the servants, the prophets. Henceforth, therefore, for there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, neither hid that shall not be known. Therefore, whatsoever ye have spoken in darkness shall be heard in the light, and that which ye have spoken in the air and closet shall be proclaimed upon the housetops. All right, let me get my next precept. 2 Thessalonians 2:8. And then shall the wicked be revealed. Matter of fact, I'll start here. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. All right. Back then, the Romans were in power. The Romans are Edomites. All right. The Romans are back here again today, ruling in modern day Rome, which is called America, Babylon the Great. It says, only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. So he's going to rule until the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled, the time of the heathens be fulfilled, all right, till the time that they're done ruling is fulfilled. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy the brightness of his coming. And that's what's happening. Esau is being revealed first and foremost by the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, by the mouth of the prophets, all right? And the Lord is ultimately going to destroy him by the brightness of his coming. Like the scripture saying, it says in Jude, it says it in the book of Peter's, that look at that ancient city that practiced all these corruptible, lustful things. What happened to them? They were made an example. They were made an example on how not to live. All right. You know what cities I'm talking about. I'm trying to say less. Anyway, because hey, another thing, that famine here in the word is coming. There was a pastor who was out there preaching during one of those events, and he got locked up. You know, they locked him up. I believe they seized his Cash App account, something along those lines. You know, they taking out the Bible out of these schools because it's anti, you know what, and this and that. So yeah, famine here in the word is coming. All right. And as I was meditating on it yesterday, when they do come with the famine here in the word, the main people they really going to target, they want to target all the Israelites, but the main ones is Great Millstone, in the name of, because when they come with that sea ragamuffin, that sea hip, that Revelation 13:16 on down, the main ones that's really talking about it and bringing it up and constantly blowing the trumpet is Great Millstone. All right, Great Millstone, GMS from the Apostles on down. So I could see them starting with the, you know, trying to take our videos out. Anybody associated with GMS videos got to go, and leaving these other guys up there. I could honestly see that happening at first, but hey, we just got to wait and see. So this is the book of Isaiah 25:7. And he will destroy in this mountain, this government, and mountain's government, the face of the covering cast over all people. All right. Because there's a covering cast over all people. All right. You look up the word. What is a covering? Covering is something that you use like a veil. All right. And the veil, the covering is the lies. All right, which is casted over these people, you know. But the Lord's gonna break that, you know. Like if you break a cast, You know, you got a cast around you, you break it. The Lord is going to break this cast that got these people trapped. And he's breaking it already. All right? Which is covered over all people. All these lies, the deception. You know, the spells, the enchantments. The Lord is breaking that. It says, in the veil that is spread over all nations. And it's starting with us knowing that we're Israelites. That we are the true biblical Hebrew Israelites according to the Bible. And we're teaching that. And we're teaching the nations who they are. Telling them who they are. Telling them their destiny or their fate. You know, from Esau to the rest of the nations. We letting them know. So the Lord is going to destroy in this mountain, this government, the face of the covering cast over all these people. The lies, all right, and the veil that is spread over all nations. So now, among other things, of course, you know, Esau is lies, religion, the wine is philosophy. This is Isaiah 47, and I'll start at 12. It says, stand now with thine enchantment. Enchantment, right? Let me get that word, enchantment. In the common dictionary, enchantment is magic. It says a feeling of great pleasure or delight, and that's what these people do. They delight in their lust, their ill pleasures and delights, right? So anyway, it says magic, witchcraft, sorcery, wizardry, necromancy, conjuration, hypnotism, mesmerism, voodoo, charms, spells. What do you do with all these things? You cast them, you cast spells, you cast charms, you cast voodoo, you cast mesmerism, all right? Seduction is all spells, is all something you cast, all right? You extend, like right here, to throw, to cast, to send, to direct. They directing it towards the people, starting with the Israelites. They really want to get the Israelites because we're the ones that are under the law, statute, commandments of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shai. The law was given to us, so the penalty for breaking it is going to be grief. You know, it's going to be dire. It's going to be death. You know, and Tawadi Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, that we're under the grace. You know, through the blood of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You know, look, to throw, to cast, direct. You know. So, hey, that's, you know, that's heavy right there in itself. Okay, so enchantment. To lure, bliss, appeal. And that's how Babylon the Great come off. Beauty, ecstasy, attraction, all right? Sorcery, alluring, seductive, magnetism, pull, it draws people. That's Babylon the Great. That's Babylon the Great. And that's why the scripture said the nations are going to hate the whore because they all fell for the mousetrap. They all fell for the voodoo. They fell for the sorceries. They got prith. They got prith with Babylon's lies. They got prith with Babylon's deception, you know, and now hence they got all them demons on them. So again, it says, stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth, from the beginning, from the very, very beginning. That's what Babylon was all about. It says, if so be thou shalt be able to profit, if so be thou mayest prevail. But Babylon is not going to prevail. The Lord is going, he's going to do, you know what? He's going to say it. Let me read verse 14. Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers, the stargazers, the monthly prognosticators stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee. Because all of this is going to come to nothing. In 1 hour shall Babylon the Great be destroyed. In 1 hour. Behold, they shall be a stubble. The fire shall burn them. They shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flame. There shall not be coal, a coal to warm at, nor fire to sit before it. Thus shall they be unto thee with whom thou hast labored, even thy merchants from thy youth. They shall wander everyone to his quarter, none shall save thee. So all these nations are going to get it, starting with Babylon the Great and these other nations. They're all going to get it. They're coming back into slavery, all right, and chains and shackles. So yeah, so this, you know, I've seen this and Spirit compelled me to look up, to put those words together. Those last, the P-R-I and the T-H, you know, because there's a hidden word in between this, which is demon. And I said, let me see P-R-I-T-H. And then that's what you get. The word prith is to cast, to send. And then you got the word demon in there. So ain't nothing by coincidence. You know, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, You know, ain't nothing by coincidence, man. Look at this. That's a demon. That's a demon right there. That is a demon. All right? That is a damn demon. You know? And this is the demon that's hovering over all these people. You know? Abomination, bro. Scriptures clearly tell you what the punish, what the penalty, Leviticus 20, chapter 13, what the penalty for such act is going to be. But you know what? That's why they want to ban the Bible. So, Ababa ball. All right, destruction to Babylon. Bubba kashai, bracket the Yahubash Miyawashai. Ababa ball, destroy this place. So with that, I'm going to end it and give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahubash Miyawashai, Bashim Rakakwadash. Till next time, I say, Shalom to the Lord's elect. Shalom.